Can I take CJC Ipamorelin in the morning? Well, I'm going to talk to you in this video about why it may be beneficial to take it in the morning, how it's my preferred method, and then I'm going to share with you some research that was conducted out of Canada where they found that CJC actually had demonstrated very important effects on IGF-1. First of all, what is CJC1295? It's this really beautiful peptide, and it stimulates the growth hormone releasing pathways in your body. It works on the pituitary gland, and it mimics the pulse of growth hormone. And so growth hormone is this beautiful hormone that allows our body to heal, recover, get deep sleep. It's that hormone that you had circulating in your body in abundance when you were a kid. I remember growing up on the farm in Idaho, I'd go to bed after working 12 hours, and I would sleep so deep, and then wake up the next morning and do it all over again. And I do that every summer from about the age of maybe 10 or 11 until I left, as an adult. And it was the growth hormone that allowed me to sleep great and then continue the work the next day. So what happens as we age, though, is our growth hormone levels decline. And a lot of people have leaned into great peptides to stimulate growth hormone because we've learned that growth hormone itself, while a very powerful treatment, it is very expensive, first of all, but then there may be some side effects like organ enlargement. But even the growth hormone itself, it seems to have a very safe profile. But let's jump into CJC. And why would you use it in the morning instead of the evening? Well, first of all, CJC does cause a flushing effect. So if you've ever used this peptide, you'll notice that you can get some tingling in your body, and you'll notice your face can go red, similar to a niacin flush. That flushing is normal. It's not anything to be concerned with. However, because of that flushing, CJC 1295 can keep people awake at night. I was one of those. You know, I've used CJC 1295 in cycles off and on for over a decade. And one of the things that I found is that at night, I would get that kind of increase of my heart rate, the flushing. Even though it only lasts about 5 minutes, I found that it would stimulate my brain. I'd start having new ideas, and I'd want to read something new or jump into certain research or have conversations or jump into my business. So I realized that maybe I could take it in the morning. And so what I found is doing it in the morning was actually very nice, because with any growth hormone releasing peptide, you don't want it to have the presence of insulin. When you have insulin that's in your blood, you're going to have a competitive factor with growth hormone, and insulin supersedes growth hormone. So you have to be in a fasted state, meaning no sugar in your blood and no insulin in your blood, or very small amounts. You're not going to ever have zero. You want to have some glucose and insulin in your blood, by the way. But if it over like a fasted state, that's where you won't get the same benefits as you would in a fasted state. So naturally in the morning is a great time to do it, because you wake up, breakfast is called break fast. So before breakfast, you would want to use CJC 1295, do an injection. And then I like to go work out right after that in a fasted state. I get hydrated. That's not going to affect it. You can do ketones, which I'll do the immune IQ ketones in water. I'll put a little bit of electrolytes in there with it and get hydrated. And right after the injection, I've got that nice flushing effect. I'll go jump into my workout. And that workout is actually energized because of this CJC 1295. So if you want to try it in the morning, do that. Just give yourself about a 30-minute break between when you do the injection and when you eat. Most of the growth hormone releasing peptides are metabolized fairly quickly. So you've got about a 30-minute half-life, 30-minute metabolic rate. So probably closer to like a 15-minute half-life on CJC. So you get the benefits of it, and you don't have to stay in a fasted state long after you inject it. It's just that 90 minutes before, so that you make sure all the insulin is out of your system. So CJC, what it does is activating the growth hormone, you're going to see an even greater pulse if you add in another peptide called Ipamorelin. I've talked about this a lot on the show, how Ipamorelin, it's one of the peptides that we use with it. It does stimulate growth hormone, but it works on the ghrelin pathway. So it's one of the peptides that prevents you from getting hungry. When you use CJC 1295 alone, you may notice an increase of hunger, just like you did when you were a kid. You may notice that hunger outperforms the gains that you get from building muscle mass and having lean tissue. And so that's where Ipamorelin is important. But the other important thing about Ipamorelin is it turns off or inhibits this pathway called somatostatin. And somatostatin is a peptide that puts the lid on growth hormone. So just like any biological system, you're going to have inputs, and these inputs, they stimulate a response in your body, but there's always this braking system that happens. So with growth hormones, somatostatin is the braking system, because if your body just continually releases growth hormone, you could be a giant, like Andre the Giant, right? And it doesn't always end well, because Andre the Giant, even though he was my favorite wrestler, him and Hulk Hogan were really fun to, I had all the toys when I was a kid, but Andre the Giant, he had an overexpressed level of growth hormone. He had a disease in his pituitary, and many of you probably know what that is, so you could put it in the comments, I'd love that. But growth hormone does need to be limited, and where it's excreted the most is when you sleep. And some of the research actually suggests that if you get to bed before midnight, and that's where I have this strict policy, you know, 9 o'clock is when lights are dim, and getting in bed and ideally falling asleep by 9:30. Some days it's even earlier, because I want to get that growth hormone pulse. You know, we're ageless future is not something I take lightly. I'm like, I really want to have good energy, and so I depend on my sleep. So when you fall asleep at night, you fall into that deep delta sleep, and that's when you're getting this abundance of growth hormone. So if you can tolerate CJC 1295, taking it at night, it's a great time to take it, because you will have that extra pulse of growth hormone. One of the peptides we stack with it is called DSIP, or deep sleep inducing peptide, or delta sleep inducing peptide. This peptide was isolated from a doctor in 1957 who was working on rabbits. And he noticed that rabbits had this circadian clock, and they found that this peptide called DSIP is what influenced that circadian rhythm, the release of melatonin, the downregulation of cortisol. And so when you add CJC 1295 with DSIP, you can actually get even better sleep if you struggle with sleep. But taking CJC 1295 in the morning, you're still going to get a growth hormone pulse. You'll still get it at night, but you're also going to get it a little more in the day. It helps you recover from workouts. When you do high intensity interval trainings, like if you do sprints, you know, just try and do 10 50 yard dashes, like sprint as fast as you can 10 times. That is high intensity interval training. Let your heart rate come down, you know, walk back to the starting line, let your heart rate come down to, you know, like maybe 90 to 100, and then sprint it again, full speed. And you'll see a nice little pulse of growth hormone. And so, because I mentioned you get most of your growth hormone at night, you're also getting it when you exercise and when you work your body hard. So CJC is, and any peptide, it's not intended to be just some singular treatment protocol. You wanna make sure that you're working with qualified doctors. You wanna get it from the right pharmaceutical source. Everything we use is from licensed 503A or 503B pharmacies. And that allows us to have the purity, the structural integrity, and you're getting the full complex of CJC. So what does the research show about CJC? Does it really work, or is it some kind of like biohacking fad? Well, one of the studies that was published in the Journal of Clinical Endocrinology and Metabolism, this was published back in 2006 in Canada. And what they found is a single dose of CJC 1295 increased the serum levels of IGF-1 by 1.5 to 3 times greater up to 14 days. That's a single dose. That demonstrates its potency and effectiveness in activating the growth hormone pathways, because IGF-1 is the workhorse for growth hormone. And it also showed potential benefits for metabolism and body composition. So if you're thinking about this, think about what are your goals with CJC, and then apply some of the exercise protocols, get your protein in, and you're gonna do phenomenal. For those of you who love this video, make sure you share it with your family, friends, and loved ones. And if you want a free copy of my book, The Peptide Blueprint, we provided in the show notes below. Appreciate you.